Hi Cancer, I'm Jamila, and welcome to the Venus Experiment Channel. So this is your horoscope for the month of December of 2019. Okay, Cancer, Cancer Sun, or Cancer Moon, or Cancer Rising. So the new beginning that's coming in, it's really starting on November 26th, Tuesday, at 7:05 a.m. Pacific time, we have a new beginning for you that you'll be working with this energy all the way until our next new moon on Christmas Day. So for this month, you are building a new lifestyle and you're creating new health routines. And a lot of it has to do with really seeing and envisioning a new way of living, a new lifestyle. So let's start with seeing your perfect health. So what is perfect health for you, Cancer? So close your eyes and really see it. Envision you in your body, in your perfect health. So what is that? What does it look like? And actually seeing it and envisioning it is a huge part of what can happen here in the transformation in this month of December. It's really all about you shifting up your lifestyle and focusing on your health. And then you have a big new influence coming in December that's all about new relationships. But first, this issues of your health and your lifestyle and just your well-being, they're being cleaned out this month so you can have these new relationships that are starting. Well, really, they're coming in this month too, because Jupiter moves into your relationship house on December 3rd, which means the expansion, which has been in the areas of your health, of looking at new ways and new lifestyles, new ways of living. And now it's moved into your relationships. So what that means is for the whole year of 2020, you will be having big expansion in your relationships. New people, new clients, new friends, new coworkers, all these new others in your life are really going to be showing up and bringing in so many blessings and gifts for you all through the others in your life. So that starts December 3rd and is for a whole year. Lighting up your relationships and bringing them in. Jupiter brings energy in. And Venus is here for this new moon. So, okay, forgot about this. This is where I should have started, my dear Cancer friend. It is a lovely month for relationships. Just lovely. Venus is here. Thank goodness. And Jupiter is going to be here on the 3rd. Thank goodness, because you Cancers, you have been having so much heavy work in your relationships. Heavy, heavy work this whole year. And it's not done, but this month there's a big shift, a big change, and all that work that you've been doing on your relationships, in your relationships, it's going to pay off. It's going to pay off in this month of December and continue all of 2020. You're still going to be working on these relationship issues, but you get this grace, this ease, and this bounty coming in the house of the other. So all of these others showing up with blessings for you. So that means you got to open up to the others, because they are everywhere and they want to bring you gifts and blessings. So that means open up to any other, to any one-on-one relationship. It's about being open for you and receptive. Cancer is a receptive energy, but sometimes you guys are so busy taking care of everyone else that you're not sitting in your receptive, creative flow. That's really about allowing. That's about opening up so the energy can come in. And where it's coming in is in your relationships. So this whole year ahead is about abundance of new people in your life and new clients and new friends and new relationships that want to bring you so much. So open up to it because it's here and it's in the others in your life. So open up to all the others everywhere you go. Think of the other in your life as bringing these blessings to you because they are. And all you have to do is be open to it. And really focus on your health this month, on seeing a new healthy you. And then the full moon in the middle of the month is a difficult, not difficult one, but it's lighting up your subconscious. So please make extra time and space around this full moon, dear Cancer, because you are affected by the moons more than any other. You are ruled by the moon, my lunar being. I can totally relate. My moon's in my first house and I feel like a lunar being too. And so we are affected by the moons, and this big full moon is lighting up your subconscious. All the heavy stuff, all that dark stuff that's been hiding in your subconscious is going to be lit up. So that means all the boogeymen, all the funky stuff, that's all going to be coming out with this full moon and will likely have a real effect on your health. So these are things that you need to let go of in your subconscious that will affect your health and will bring in this new healthy you that you're building in this month of December. That's challenging. Healthy month, when you build your healthiest month and healthy changes in your life is the month of December, when the sweets and the food and the abundance of not so healthy things are everywhere. So that's a challenge for you, Cancer. So remember, keep your focus and your goals set and your eyes, your attention set on this visioning of a new healthy lifestyle. So whatever gets you there, so envisioning that healthy you, that healthy version of you, this is the time where you can really change your physical body and really bring these changes in. And it starts with these lifestyle changes. And then it finishes with the full moon where you clean out all that stuff that will likely come out around the full moon. So any of this boogeyman stuff that's coming out, allow yourself some time and space to feel it and release it. This is a big release for you. And then you come into your time. The next full moon is going to be the Cancer full moon, about really letting go of an old identity. But this is letting go of your subconscious and all of these blocks that were hindering your health. So this is the time to create health, good health. And all of these relationship blessings, they can help your health. Just want to be conscious about your choices, every little tiny choice in your day-to-day life, and how is it connected to that vision of your highest self, of your physical health? So just spend as much time as possible seeing it and envisioning it. And then when you make those day-to-day lifestyle choices, choose them from that perspective, from that highest vision of your health, because this is the one month of the year that you can really make these lifestyle changes. And like I said before, December, that's a tough one, dear Cancer, but you can do it. Doesn't mean you need to go on a diet. No, that's not what I meant. But just be conscious of your choices in your lifestyle. And is that aligned with that vision of your perfect health? And sit and meditate and see your healthy body and what it feels like. Really see it, because there's some power in our visioning, in our seeing. That's what the Sagittarius power is, in seeing and envisioning. And for you, it's about your health, your physical body, your work, and your lifestyle. So make those changes and start with just seeing. and get ready for some letting go of this month of December. So give yourself some time and some space, especially around that full moon. And know that all that, any darkness coming out is coming out so it can be released. So give yourself some extra room around that full moon for extra sleep, like allowing as much as possible for just being in bed and sleeping. Okay, dear Cancer friend, thanks for coming and listening all the way to the end today. And I hope you have a beautiful month of December and rebuild your life in a healthy way. Yay! Okay, Cancer friend, I hope to see you soon. Have a beautiful December and a beautiful month and a beautiful day. And I'll see you soon.